Hi friends, welcome to Sada Learning Hub. You are with me, Sadashiv Rao. In this video, I'm going to discuss about most important differences between methods. If you see in the Hibernate, there is a different, so many methods are available. In the interview perspective, there is a some methods are there, where there is a some differences are there between the methods, but behaviors are the same. Now, in this video, I'm going to discuss about those differences and their methods. The first method is, what is the difference between a load and a get method? See, load and get method, both methods are going to use to get the data from the database. Both methods are going to use to load to get the data from database. Load method performs the lazy loading, but get method performs the early loading. Here, lazy loading means to get the only proxy objects, and early loading means to get the real object. Proxy object means whenever you are loading the proxy object, if the object is not available, it returns the exception, object not found exception. If it is the early loading, directly it is going to return an null value into the object. If a given ID is not exist in the database, then load method throws object not found exception. But coming to the get method, it returns the null. These are the two differences. These are major two differences between a load and a get method. Load method is the lazy loading and get method is the early loading. Load method throws an object not found exception and get method returns a null value. The next differences is differences between update and merge method. See, both are same. It is going to update an existing object, but some differences are there between a update method and a merge method. Update and merge methods are used to convert an object states from detached state to persistent state. These are the two methods, update method and merge method. Both methods are used to convert an object state from detached state to persistent state. Detached state means the state obtained by an object, the state obtained by an object after coming out from the session cache. Detached state means the state obtained by an object after coming from the session cache. In the inheritance, a session cache can allows only one object of a pojo class within the same identifier. If the another one is going to either into the cache with the same identifier, then Hibernate throws an exception. If you see, update and merge methods are used to convert an object state to detached state to persistent state. Detached state means the state obtained by an object after coming out from the session cache. In the Hibernate, a session cache can allows only one object of a pojo class with the same identifier. If another one is going to enter into the cache with the same identifier, then Hibernate throws an exception. That is the those are the differences between update method and merge method. Coming to the next question, what is the differences between save and save or update method? What is the differences between save or update method? Whenever save method is called, then Hibernate checks the ID of the object is not available in the database or not. Whenever you are saving the whenever you are calling the save method is called, then Hibernate checks the ID of the object is not available in the database or not. If not available, then the object will be solved. Otherwise, an exception will be thrown. Means whenever you are calling the save method, simply it is going to insert the record into the database. If the object is available, means if the ID, if the record is available in the database, simply it throws an exception. Coming to the save or update method, in the save or update method, there is no concept of exception. If the object is available, simply it is going to update that particular object. If the object is not available, simply it is going to create a new record into the database. That is the difference between save and saveOrUpdate, means only the exception difference. Coming to the next question, differences between save and persist method. What is the differences between save and the persist method? Save method return type is serializable and persist method return type is void. Save method return type is serializable and persist method return type is void. Means persist method doesn't return anything. Coming to the save method, it returns the serializable object. If you call the save method, then it will save the object in the database and also it returns the ID of the object back to the Java application. But if you call the persist method, then it will save the object into the database, but it doesn't return any ID to the any ID of the object. When generator class is other than assign, then ID of the object will be generated by the Hibernate. If you want to get the ID generated by the Hibernate, then we need to use the save method. If you want to need a primary key column, definitely we need to use the save method. Save method returns the primary key value, identifier. In case of generator classes is assigned, we manually assign the ID of the object, so we can call persist in that case. Whenever you are assigning the primary key value, that time you no need to call the save method. Why? Because you already know the primary key. In that case, you need no need. Simply, we are going to use persist method to save the object into the database. In Java, if a method returns some value, then it is an optional store return the value into the some variable. So when the save method is called, it is an optional to store the ID returned by the method into the same serializable object. Those are the differences between a save and the persist methods. The next differences are, what are the differences between open session and get current session? There is a two sessions available. What are the differences between open session and get current session? See, in case of session object, it always create a new session object. It always create a new session object. Coming to the get current session, it creates a new session if not exist. Else use the same session which is in current Hibernate context. It doesn't create any new session. If it is session is available, it is going to use that session. If it is session is not available, it is going to create a new session in case of get current session. The next difference is flush and close. You need explicitly flush and close the session object in case of open session. If you are using the open session, definitely you need to explicitly flush and close the session object. Coming to get current session, you don't need to flush and close the session object. It will be automatically taken care by the Hibernate internally. Here, we no need to do. It will take care by the Hibernate. No need to close things. It will be automatically take care by the Hibernate. Coming to the in case of performance, in the single threaded environment, it is slower than get current session. If you see in case of get current session, it is a single threaded environment, it is faster than get open session. These are the different. If you see in a single threaded environment, in case of open session, it is slower than get current session. In case of get current session, it is a faster than get open session. Coming to the configuration perspective, open session, you don't need to configure any property to call this method. See here, if you want to call the open session method, you no need to call any, no need of any configurations. But if you are using the get current session method, definitely you need to do some configuration. We need to add some additional property, hibernate.currentSessionContext class. This is the property we need to configure in Hibernate configuration file to call getCurrentSession method. Otherwise, it will throws an exception. If you are not configuring this configuration in the Hibernate configuration file, definitely it throws an exception. This is the differences between open session and the get current session. This is about open session and get current session. These are the major differences. These are the major differences in the Hibernate interview prospective also. These are very, very useful, most important questions. That is about differences between most important differences between different methods. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and share this video. Thank you for watching.